Welcome to the webcast on integrating Visual Studio and MetaEdit Plus. Today, developers and development teams face challenges on combining the use of models and code. While almost all companies create, in a format or another, specification models or design models, they can't be fully utilized during actual implementation. So typically models are thrown away at some point of time. Reason for this is partly in the modeling languages used and partly in the tool support. On the programming language side, we all know that different implementation tasks require different programming languages, as well as their related frameworks and libraries. The same applies for modeling languages too. With the domain-specific modeling language, so with a language that fits for our purpose, we can much better use models and utilize them in implementation. The other reason for the challenges on using models with the code is the tool support. We need to have tools that are open for integration and communication. Let me demonstrate this with an example, using Visual Studio on the programming side and MetaEdit Plus on the modeling side. What I have here is a small example, different digital wristwatches. The code I have here in Visual Studio is partly generated, like the application code here, and partly written manually, like the framework and libraries. So what we can do is we can run the digital wristwatch functions. And here we have actually five different kind of watch products, and I choose the ACE model, and here you can see the sample watch running. So we are currently in a time application, and then by pressing buttons, we can move into a stopwatch application, and here we can see the different time units, and then we also have icons to see that what kind of function we are using. So let's add here lap time functionality. So when running the time, we would like to freeze the display to show the current elapsed time, for example, by pressing the down button. And if we would be pressing down button again, then we would be able to see the running application again. For this purpose, for adding this lap time functionality, we will use domain-specific models. And here in Visual Studio, I can open the MetaEdit extension for Visual Studio, which allows me now to navigate in the models. And I can open the models in MetaEdit Plus, and here you can see a sample domain-specific language describing the stopwatch application, so what we selected here in Visual Studio. And now we could add here the lap time functionality, but now I'm using the watch-specific concepts like actions, alarms, buttons, icons, and things like that. So I add here a new state, I call it lap time. And then we can go to this lap time if we press the down button. I copied the existing definition here. And now this domain-specific language allows me to say that, well, if I press down button, then we go to a lap time. And if I press the down button again, then we go to a running state. If I want to do some silly things, something that are not allowed in this domain, like connect it to this icon, the language guides me that only allows me to make legal kind of models. To complement and finalize our application, let's add here also one action to calculate the lap time. So I'll again use these variables here and specify the arithmetics for this time calculation. And this small language now allows us to say that let's take a system time minus start time, and let's put the result to the stop time. So now we have done our design. Next we can try it out whether this will work. For studying how this will work, I actually would like to animate my models. So I choose a generator that rather than using the basic C# generator, I use animation code generator with MetaEdit Plus API. So if I now run the auto-build code generator here, I'll get the code here for my modified code is now generated code that is being now modified for my stopwatch application appears here. And then if I run the ACE product again, and I move into a stopwatch application, actually I can see here my states being animated. So if you now press the up button, icons puts on, and now we are in a running state. But if I now press the down button, now we went to this lap time state, and only if we press down button again, these other buttons don't do anything, only if we press down button again, now we went back to the running state. So I would like to emphasize that the code we are running now is actually generated from this model and being incorporated and integrated into Visual Studio and built there. The MetaEdit extension for Visual Studio is available at Visual Studio Gallery. It provides also support for Visual Studio to use multiple integrated domain-specific languages, as well as support different kind of representations. While I demonstrated here only diagrams, the models can be also expressed as matrices or tables too. Visual Studio and MetaEdit Plus provide good ways to integrate tools. So flexible tools and domain-specific languages allow combining the best parts of the both worlds. You can also access the source code and development guide from Google Codeplex for the MetaEdit Plus extension. Thank you for watching this video. Happy coding. Happy modeling.